The last video we talked about what the rank had to do with the null space of the matrix, that is to say, the set of all solutions to Ax equals 0. In this video we're going to talk about the rank and the column space. So if we have a matrix, let's think of it as being made up of its columns laid side by side, then the column space is by definition the span of those columns, that is to say, all possible linear combinations of the columns of A. Well, how do you take a linear combination? Well, you take an arbitrary number x1 and multiply by the first column, and x2 times the second column, xn times the nth column. In other words, you pick an arbitrary vector in Rn to give you coefficients, and you take the linear combination. But that's exactly what the product of a matrix Ax is. So the column space is all the things that can be expressed as A times x. Or to put it another way, it's all vectors B in Rm such that you have can find a solution to Ax equals B. Okay, so the big result is that you can find a basis for the column space by just looking at the pivot columns of the original matrix. If something has three pivots, if the rank is three, well then you have a basis with three vectors. In other words, the column space is three-dimensional. So the rank tells you how big is the column space, but it tells you more than, and if you know where the pivots are, that tells you what the basis actually is. So let's do an example. We'll do our running example where A is given by this matrix. And as we've worked out several times, you put it in reduced row echelon form, and you get this matrix, and you say, aha, I've got a pivot in the first column, second column, and fourth column. So we call the first, second, and fourth columns the pivot columns. Okay. So our basis for the column space is going to be the first, second, and fourth columns. But not the first, second, and fourth columns of this. The first, second, and fourth columns of the original matrix A. In other words, these three vectors, and not the first, second, and fourth columns of the reduced row echelon form. You can see pretty quickly that, of course, this is in the column space because it is a column, and it's not a linear combination of these three guys because these all have zeros at the bottom. You do not want the columns of the reduced row echelon form. You want the columns of the original matrix. So let's see why this works. We worked out the solutions to Ax equals 0, and we did that by figuring out the reduced row echelon form and finding the solutions to A, RREF, x equals 0. And we saw that negative 4, negative 2, 1, 0 was a solution. Great. Well, that means it's also a solution to Ax equals 0, because these two systems of the equations have the exact same solutions. But now remember what Ax means. Ax is a linear combination of the columns of A. So if A times negative 4, negative 2, 1, 0 is 0, that means that negative 4 times the first column minus 2 times the second column plus the third column is 0, which means that we can write that third column as 4 times the first plus 2 times the second. So the third column is a linear combination of the first two. So if we're coming up with a So we don't need it as a part of our spanning set. All the things that we can get as a combination of the first, second, third, and fourth columns, we can get as a combination of the first, second, and fourth columns without the third, because the third is just a combination of the first and second. So what about the ones that are left, the first, second, and fourth? Well, if they were linearly dependent, then we could find a linear combination that was zero. In other words, we could find a solution to Ax equals 0 that didn't involve x3. But the only solution that has x3 equals 0 is 0. The only solutions to Ax equals 0 are the free variable times negative 4, negative 2, 1, 0. So if you don't have x3, the other variables are 0 as well. You don't have a non-trivial linear combination. So that means that the rest of the columns of A, A1, A2, and A4, are linearly independent. They're linearly independent. They span the column space. They form a basis for the column space. We can use the same argument in general. If you take any old matrix A, and if you have a free variable, then you can always find a solution where that free variable is equal to 1, and all of the other free variables are equal to 0, because they're free variables. You can set them to whatever you want. So you can set this one to 1 and the rest to 0. But that means you can find you apply that solution, you get 1 times that column, 0 times all of the other free columns, and some combination of the pivot columns. But that means that AK is a linear combination of the pivot columns. You put this on the other side, and minus linear combination is still a linear combination. And so it's redundant. We don't need it. We can throw out all of the pivot columns. And when you're left, sorry, all the free columns, what you're left with is the pivot columns. But there aren't any solutions to AX equals 0 that don't involve the free variables, because if you set all the free variables equal to 0, then all of the pivot variables also have to be equal to 0. So the pivot columns that are left are linearly independent. And so we have proved our basic theorem, which is that the pivot columns of the original matrix form a basis for the column space, and so the dimension of the column space is the rank.